Fuck her right in the pussy.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me and you'll be in a world of Daddy Trump's creation.
Take my hand and a stand
against illegal immigration.
Build a wall, make it tall, traveling in a safer, whiter nation.
What we'll see will defy explanation.
Actually, it makes a lot of sense if you understand evolution, darling.
If you want to view paradise, simply get rid of Drew Meaty.
Giant tropical centipedes share their territories with tarantulas. Despite its impressive length, it's a nimble navigator, and some can be highly venomous.
You know, targeted audience, when in fact white people have dominated the world since the beginning of history.
Well, we invented all the good shit.
Well, actually, you know,
once again, please join me in welcoming to Ann Arbor, Milo Yiannopoulos.
Centipede.
When you hear Milo argue this point, he'll talk about women working different hours, and he'll talk about the glorious joy of motherhood and how it's the most important thing a woman can do.
You've looked me up on YouTube.
Did I fucking wake up in the 1950s? Right? No, we were on the same program and I was in the green room and I just couldn't believe what I was hearing. Now, of course, I'm not going to use any statistics tonight, because everybody can come back and make up their own research, which Milo does on a regular basis.
A few moments later.
So, for example, female finance specialists, judges and lawyers make between, respectively, 66% and 82% of their male counterparts. He was clearly saying all men are potential rapists because he was saying he couldn't control his own sexuality. Now, why have you bought this view of yourselves? Those of you that think that, those of you that think it's fine for a man to grab a woman, squeeze her nipple and shove his filthy tongue down her throat and for her to feel fine about it because she's not a special snowflake. In what way is that all right?
You're addressing people in the hall like anyone thinks that. You said, you know, in what way, which among you have taken on this point of view of we're all potential rapists? I don't think anybody here has. You obviously spoke to a disturbed individual. That's not reflective of all men.
No, it's not. Reflective of all men.
And the fact that he's not representative of all men is why some of us prefer data to anecdote.
This is
and it's a nice story, but it is meaningless.
Wow.
Confirm.
They're telling me what I can find funny. Well, that isn't funny. I find AIDS quite funny. I find Islam quite funny. I find all sorts of things that I'm not supposed to... What's that?
Aloha.
Aloha, Snowball, yeah.
I find trannies quite funny. I mean, all these things are inherently very entertaining, but we're told that we can't laugh about them because we're offending someone.
Oh.
Madam, I'm grateful to you for coming, but to be quite honest with you, fuck your feelings.
Confirm kill.
Off you go. Off you go. Off you go. I'm sorry, darling, this isn't the Silverhaired Snowflake show. This is the Milo show, and it's time for you to go.
I think it's about confidence. I think women suffer. Again, we're not talking about all women, we're talking about some women, we're talking about some men, from lack of confidence and from something called imposter syndrome, where we attribute our successes to external factors and we lack the confidence to actually believe that we are good enough to do it.
Sorry to interrupt you, but you know, if you're going to get put off a career in science because of an offhand comment from a Nobel Prize winner, how committed were you really in the first place to being
that's
a scientist?
I mean, it's a
This is based on an assumption that there ought to be some kind of gender parity. My suggestion is that there isn't. We don't complain when women dominate subjects like nursing. We shouldn't complain when men dominate subjects like physics.
We're going to have to leave it there. We could chat for another hour on this. Milo, Doctor, thank you both very much indeed for joining us here on Sky News. We'll continue this discussion.
One protester, he's gonna go talk to him.
No fucking way.
Take me over to him. I bought you some water, are you okay?
I'm fine, thank you.
What's that with you? You're the only person.
I'd rather not speak with you, thank you.
You'd rather not? Why? What
I'd
does it say?
I'd rather not speak with you.
Milo, I'm gay too. Do not represent. Well, I've never said I did, darling. You're the only person here. Do you feel lonely? I don't think he wants to talk to you very much, but I'm going to leave you some water. You get tired, they'll come and they'll bring you in, all right? And come and enjoy the show with everybody else, you poor little angel. Aww. And of course, beyond the sex it is,
some men are retreating into slightly horrendous other things. We have produced another pathetic, monstrous creature as a result of this phenomenon known as the male feminist. This is about the most depressingly hilarious creation of modern life. A man who hates himself and his fellow man so much that he will say and do and believe literally anything that some dumpy fat lesbian blogger tells him because he thinks he might get laid. Well, I can tell you the best these guys ever get is an unsatisfying handy in the back of a car. Women don't want this. They don't. Even those eyes. But they don't. They don't. Now, you're unlikely to get laid if you're part of the sexodus, but celibacy is practically guaranteed as a male feminist. Which might be why so many of them turn out to either be virgins, perverts, or both.
Get wrecked, onion boy.
But that's not true. I mean, the point is that the gap is there still, and older women in particular suffer more from it from younger women. We shouldn't just leave older women, you know, to flounder, should we? Just because they were part of a generation where
no,
it was even
I'm
more difficult for them to get on.
I'm making a specific explanation about where these figures come from, and you haven't really addressed the point that I'm making. What I'm saying is that you can only create this gender gap when you take a broad brush across all genders, all sectors, all work. That doesn't reflect the different choices people make, and employers aren't, you know, shouldn't be forced to pay a full-time salary to somebody who works part-time. You haven't come up with a solution to that, and you haven't addressed the problem with the figures, which is that no serious economist treats the gender pay gap as a problem to be solved. No economist thinks this is a problem because they realize what I'm explaining.
Is that male economists or female economists, just to be clear?
You should know by now that when Milo laughs, it's game over for you stupid feminist bitches.
Well, I mean, most of my figures on this from is from a feminist female academic, Christina Hoff Summers, at the American Enterprise Institute in the US.
Fuck her right in the pussy!
Confirmed kill. Confirmed kill.
Like it's... So, you know...
The following clip shows a feminist, debating that women are as good as men at playing chess. Can she stump the Milo, or will she be sent back to the cotton fields with shame? Let's find out.
It's almost victim blaming in a way to suggest that the reason why there's an overrepresentation of a particular kind of person is because the other kind of person just isn't quite up to it. Like, it's ridiculous. If that was the case, we don't live in a meritocracy. So.
It's nice to have these sort of vague... waffly, sort of everyone has varied interests. What the science suggests is that, for example, when it comes to IQ, IQ is distributed differently between the sexes. Now, IQ gets a really bad rap because it's not a great indicator of some things. It's said to be sexist, it's said to be biased towards white people, whatever. The point is that it tests, in this case, it tests all of the skills that make you good at chess really well. It's about puzzles, it's about games. Exactly the skills that make you good at chess make you good at IQ. Now, the way that IQ is distributed differently in the sexes is that women tend to cluster around the mean. Women are more likely to have an IQ that is somewhere near the average, whereas men go right to the top or right to the bottom more often, which is why you get great genius male artists and philosophers, but it's also why men fill the prisons, because men seem to occupy more of the ends of the IQ scale. And now IQ is pretty much the best measure we have to predict whether somebody will be good at chess.
And what it also proves is that men and women can talk forever. It's been a pleasure talking to you both. We're going to leave it there. Thank goodness we're all different.
Yes, indeed. Thanks.
Can you tell who lost the debate? Subscribe for more feminist videos.